Of all the Olympians crowding in to visit the White House this week, no one took a stranger route than Meb Keflezighi from California. At 37, he's had a long, strange trip indeed.
Ran into an accident, and I wanted to get good grades, and look at now, I'm a three-time Olympian.
Meb's family fled war-torn Eritrea when he was just a child, seeking refuge in the United States. They landed with no money, no command of English, but Meb soon discovered he had a gift for running, at first just to get a good grade in gym class.
So I just ran as hard as I can to get out an A, because that's what my parents expect me.
Through college, he steadily grew faster. And in 2004, he took silver at the Olympics in Athens, America's first marathon medal since Frank Shorter in the 1970s. In 2008, he broke his hip in the Olympic trials and failed to make the team, although he still finished eighth. The next year, he won the New York Marathon, the first American to do that in almost 30 years. And this year, he not only became the oldest marathoner ever to win the U.S. Olympic trials, he went on to capture an astonishing fourth place in London. His feet so badly blistered, he could not even walk to board his airplane home.
I did think of dropping out about mile 15 and 13, but I said, it's not my best. My best, when we made the team, I said, we hope we can represent our country to the best we can. I said, we're going to represent our country. And by stopping was not the best that I could do. I always say run to win. That means the best that I can.
Hello, Team USA!
So, the visit to the White House was a very special one for Marathon Meb. At an age when many athletes are already retired, he is still raising the American flag in a sport we have not dominated for a very long time. Tom Foreman, CNN, Washington.